So this cubes are in your table, which is lying there. You pick up the cube. This cube is 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 inch by 1 inch by 1 inch. If 1 inch by 1 inch by 1 inch cube, each side become 2 inch, what will happen? How much time? What is the growth? One inch by 1 inch by 1 inch cube becomes 2 inch by 2 inch by 2 inch. What is the area? Eight fold. You're doubling each corner, but resultant is coming out to be? That 8-fold is next cube. The size of this cube and size of this cube, so this becomes a business 8 times. Just by just doubling each by double, we are getting an outcome which is a 8-time outcome. Now, if you pick up a larger cube, you start from a customer, any business start from a customer, which is on the right corner, it's written one, number one. So you have a customer capital, customer is asset. Lot of time our capital we see in an industry is a finance capital. We say what is the revenue, what is the profit. We normally work on one capital, which is called finance capital. So lot of measurement in the society or entrepreneurship measurement revolves around finance capital, which is one capital, which is only one capital. It's not the six capital, because one capital, if you want to push on one capital, double will not become 8 times. So customer capital, when it's there, who delivers to the customer capital? The people deliver, employees deliver, that is the second capital. So first, who is your customer? Second is who are delivering to the customer, is the human capital. Third is what intellectual property you are bringing into the capital. In IP capital is whether it's a method, is a process, is a manufacturing system, it's all intellectual property. Intellectual property doesn't mean that something has to be registered to the IP office of intellectual property. The way you run, the way you supply chain manage the resources is all intellectual property. Every company has some different dimension of that intellectual property. So there's a third capital, which is IP capital. And fourth is your execution, how good your delivery is. When you go to Amazon, it's not about the website, it's about the delivery, it's about execution. There will be many sites which is there which is as good as picking up the order, but may not be as good as delivering the order. Once these four capitals are there, then you come to the finance capital, fifth brand capital. What brand you are creating is the fifth capital. And if five capitals are in place, finance capital automatically comes in. So a lot of time we start reverse on this cuboid. We start from finance capital first, and then we build everything else around it. So our thinking process in entrepreneurship starts from finance capital first. That keeps other things not in the right perspective. So if any entrepreneurship has to start, we need to look at it, what pain of the customer are we solving? This is the customer. Because we are funded by the customer. Our venture is funded by the customer. And that funding of the customer is done by you are resolving some pain of the customer. And somebody is resolving it. So initially you are the only one who is resolving it as an expert. You start the company, who is the founder of the company. Then you start building that capability to other people. Then what process are you using to solve that problem? Like what we did in programming. We write a template of programming so that 20 programmers can do it, because initially nobody wants to join you. So we get third divisioner BCom people who can do the programming for us, because for a fresh company, who will join me? No engineer will like to put a stake for joining a 2-member company. So you pick up those people who are, and then how do you get the delivery out of them? Because the third divisioner BCom guy, and you ask them to write a program. So you have to have a methodology of very sharp methodology which doesn't allow him to make an error. And then coming to your execution, your commitment and promise to the customer, and then it creates a brand. Brand is word of mouth. We say, I don't have a brand. We all have a brand. as an individual, we have a brand. When you start up a startup company, that is also a brand. You may not be knowing what your brand is, but brand is present with even a startup company will have a brand. So when you constantly say, I have to build a brand, it's a somewhat wrong statement. What brand you want to build, that may be a better statement, that I want to build this kind of a brand. So defining what type of brand I want to build up, I want to build up a customer service brand, I want to build up an innovation brand, I want to build up a brand. So it's like a personality what I want to create. But brand exists. If four capitals are there, brand is normally there. It may be word of mouth. If you don't define it, somebody else will define it.